Hi there! In this video, I will tell you about what you can do in your household and buildings to improve your current energy demand and what you need to do to take care that your greenhouse gas emissions are effectively reduced and eventually become zero. As a first step to structure your efforts, what you can do is to reduce your demand. So in this case, reducing the amount of kilowatt hours you use. The second step is the cascading of resources, so the reuse of waste streams. So for one process, you forward it to another and use it there as an input, but then with a lower quality demand. The third thing you can do is multi-sourcing. This means that you use renewable and sustainable energy sources to cover your energy demand. So to fill these somewhat abstract terms, I will show you some examples for each of these steps. Starting with demand minimization. This means that you do something what we normally call passive solutions. So you install or design something that reduces your energy demand all the time. One prominent example for this reduction is insulation. If you improve the insulation, you directly decrease the heat losses that you have to the outside, and by that your heating demand. So what I could do as a person, I could wear another layer and by that efficiently reduce my heat demand. If you now want to improve your cooling and reduce your body temperature, I could think of better ventilation. So I take care that my body temperature is regulated. Or if I'm cold and I want to make best use of the sunlight, what I can do is I can turn towards the sun where it's warmer. Now, how does this now translate to a building? What you can do, for instance, for a building, you could install another additional insulation layer. That's normally something done for existing buildings. Or you use really well insulating building materials if you buy a new one. For cooling and ventilation, you can use mechanical or natural ventilation. By that, you keep the inside temperature low with minimal efforts. To make good use of the sun and its heat and light, you can orientate the larger surfaces of your building towards the sun, so in the northern hemisphere to the south. Furthermore, you would increase the glass surface to that side to let heat and light in, while you reduce them on the north side, so you reduce their heat losses. If you want to efficiently reduce electricity demand, the simplest way to get rid of is to get rid of your old-fashioned appliances and go for new, less energy-consuming ones. So, for instance, you can use more effective light bulbs than in the past. So with these LED lights and other light sources, you could use only a fraction of your previous energy demand while providing the same amount of light in the room. The second step, what you can do, is to cascade or reuse energy. This is most often limited to the reuse of heat and cold, but then at different temperatures than the original process. One example that does show this idea somewhat is the following. If you want to boil your eggs for breakfast in the morning, you usually have hot water left at the end. And usually, you do nothing with it. You just throw it away. What you nevertheless could do is use that hot water for something else. For example, for pouring a nice cup of tea. Well, this is a bit far-fetched and not essentially that tasty. Nevertheless, it shows that we've got waste streams in our household that we can use for something else, where we can apply the principle of reusing waste streams. So you've got hot water coming from your shower or from your sink. You can use them to preheat the incoming cold water from your water supply line before it actually enters the heating kettle. By that, the temperature is already increased before entering it, and you need less heating energy. Furthermore, what you can think of is using reject heat from cooling, such as an ice rink to warm a swimming pool. Sounds a bit strange, reject heat from cooling, doesn't it? But have you ever touched the rear of your fridge at home? This is quite hot there, and you can use that heat for something else. So, for example, heating your bathroom. Now, demand minimization and cascading will get you only that far. You will eventually end up with a minimized energy demand, but you still have to cover that part. And this is where multi-sourcing enters the game. And multi-sourcing here means, like already said before, the use of renewable and sustainable energy sources. Most of you will have heard about the emerging and sometimes already applied technology in this field. So, for instance, the use of photovoltaic panels which convert sunlight into electricity. You can find them on small-scale applications like this calculator or streetlights. You can also think of installing them on your roof so you could provide electricity for your building, or if you even think on a larger scale, you can have whole fields of them. If you want to increase the scale even further, you cannot use PV anymore, but you normally would switch to something what is called a solar tower or a solar throw, where you focus the sunlight in one spot. By that you create high temperatures. These high temperatures are then used to provide steam, and the steam is used in a steam turbine to produce electricity. What you also can do is, you can use wind turbines. This might be a small one, and it also doesn't produce electricity, but nevertheless, wind can play a tremendous role in future in our energy supply. Where you would install them is normally at locations where you've got A, high wind speeds, and where these high wind speeds are normally constant. So you've got a high constant energy output. These locations can be either onshore or offshore, and you can use just one of them, or you can have whole parks of them. There are many researchers, technologists, and inventors busy with new technologies and ways to provide sustainable energy for everyone. So for instance, in Wageningen, researchers work on ways how to use plants to produce electricity in a concept that is called Plant E. While this might be currently only be one small plant, there are plans to use whole fields of this to produce electricity in future. And there are many other ideas out there that might make a breakthrough. So, are you the one that will bring us the light?